And now we call upon a few of our founder members, Mr. A.J. Abdul Razak, Senior Minister of State, Foreign Affairs and former Member of Parliament, Singapore. With these luminaries. So without further ado, it's time to welcome Dr. T. Kamal Sharif.
You are chief guest of this morning's function. Honorable Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, Muftis Mohammed Saeed Saad, Karafir Bhai, and of course my colleagues, the same. Sleep. Dreams are those which do not.
Respected CM of Jammu and Kashmir, Mufti Mohammed Saheb, Prince of Arcot, Nawab Abdulli Saheb, Padma Bhushan, Muzaffar Azam Saheb. Good to be speaking at this fantastic gathering. Actually didn't expect that it's going to be a full house like this, so thank you very much to all of you for coming and making it such a success. Being a Saturday and yesterday, of course, you must have seen the torrential rains which were there. Meeting with many of the dignitaries on the dais and many of you was such an eye-opener and of course a very, very great learning experience. I cannot forget when we had gone to Srinagar to meet our Honorable Chief Minister, the demeanor and the way which he received us, I was, to say the least, incredibly inspired. So, you saw the video a little bit about the UEF, but just for good order's sake, let me give you a little background. Of course, it was started in 1979 by my father, philanthropist, educationalist, Dr. B.S. Abdulrahman. Of course, at that time and now, I think the intention is to enable a platform like this. He was a great, for all of you, all of those who have known him, he was always trying to bring people together. You know, his idea of having people meeting, lunches, dinners, breakfast, it was always, you know, how do you bring the society for the society? Our target is to enable roughly 10,000 crores of value, which is roughly $1.5 billion. We want to tie up very closely with the Make in India team. We want to tie up with the Honorable Chief Ministers of Tamil Nadu and of Jayalalitha's Vision 2023 document. And we are hoping that we will be able to bring together sovereign wealth funds, Sharia compliant funds, Islamic banking, private equity funds and whatnot, so that we create this economic value for the society and our community.
This is the earliest contribution of Iran and cooperation of Iran with India, and I am here just to renew our commitment to expand relations with this state as well as with all India.